Caitlin from the Ontario Science Centre, and today I have an awesome experiment for you to try at home that will teach you more about how we taste. Special shout out to the grade 5s who may have learned about taste buds this year already. So, how does our tongue work? Have you ever looked at your tongue up close in the mirror and seen all those little bumps? Those are called papillae. Most papillae contain taste buds, and taste buds have microscopic sensitive hairs called microvilli, which send messages to the brain about how something tastes, whether it tastes sweet, salty, sour, or bitter. Have you ever seen this tongue map before? Scientists used to believe that our tongue was separated into different zones for tasting sweet, salty, acidic or sour, and bitter flavors. But scientists have found that this was misleading information. In fact, all of our taste buds can taste these flavors, and there are no distinct zones. There are even taste buds on the roof of our mouth and in the back of our throat. Some parts of our tongue might be more sensitive to certain flavors over others, but that will only be a small difference. Not only that, but scientists have found a fifth basic taste. It's called umami. Umami roughly translates to deliciousness in Japanese. Umami is that intense savory flavor that we get when we eat foods like Parmesan cheese, fresh tomatoes, mushrooms, soy sauce, and cooked meats. MSG is often added to foods to give it that umami flavor. So let's bust this myth of the tongue map and see how our tongues taste. All you'll need for this experiment is 4 cups, some cotton swabs, something salty, like table salt, something bitter, like coffee, something sweet, like honey, and something sour, like lemon juice. You'll also need a pen or pencil, a piece of paper, and a little bit of water. Remember, never try an experiment without asking an adult first. Better yet, get them to do it with you, and then you can compare results. First thing you're gonna do is distribute all the ingredients into their own cup. For the dry ingredients, you're gonna add a little bit of water. So I'm gonna add a little bit of water to my coffee and to my salt. Next step, we're gonna draw a tongue map similar to the one I showed you earlier, but we're gonna make the center of the tongue a fifth tasting zone. If you'd like to test for umami as well, go ahead and grab an extra glass and something savory, like soy sauce or tomatoes, crushed or juiced. But remember, if we don't have these items at home, there's no need to go out and get them. Let's use what we have in our fridge already. And make sure to ask an adult first. Next, you're going to use your Q-tip and dab it into one of the ingredients. For example, I'm gonna try the honey on all 4 zones of my tongue. The front side, the back side, and the very back. Make sure to re-dip as needed, but don't mix flavors. You're gonna record your results on your tongue map. For example, if you tasted sour at the back of your tongue the strongest, you're gonna write sour back there on your tongue map. Repeat this step for all of the ingredients. It's okay if you taste one thing, like sweet, on multiple parts of your tongue really strongly. Record that. In between tastes, make sure you cleanse your palate with a glass of water. When you're done, compare your results with the tongue map. Was it accurate? Were there any similarities, any differences? And did you try this experiment with anybody else in your household? If so, compare your results, but make sure to share it with us as well.